a little piece of plastic, but it makes a huge difference in people's lives. It helps put them back together a little bit, both physically and psychologically. After you've lost something, you can become very self-conscious about it, especially when it's your face. This little piece of plastic becomes a part of them. There's probably 100 different ways to make an eye. Everybody has their own methods and practices. Anytime I make an eye for someone, even if I made their previous one, the goal is always to make it better than the last one. When I was making art, I would make huge canvases and big sculptures and try and get everyone to see my art. And now when I do my best work, nobody notices. The margin of error on these things is really small. Suggest people don't come in too stoned. I'll have people say, oh, my eyes aren't this red. And I think, well, how am I supposed to paint them? Paint just goes on in layers, layer after layer. There it is. I like it. So one time my daughter, I think she was about 7 or 8, she was carrying this stick around, and an adult said, hey, be careful with that stick, you're gonna put your eye out. And she said, well, it doesn't matter, because my dad can make me another one just like it. When I do get to make an eye that looks like the Terminator or an alligator or something, it's a lot of fun for me. And I think it's a lot of fun for the patient. I think it's also healing. When you go through that grieving process, when you can own it and own who you are, and when that sense of loss is no longer a source of insecurity for you, I think it's healthy. And I think drawing attention to it is also healthy for the psyche as well. Actually, I have the first eye I ever painted. I was 5.
So what'd you think? Tell us in the comments. Click here to subscribe and live forever. Click here for more stuff from us. And tune in every Sunday to watch more videos that calm the soul. Bye!